I'm unable to see Dr. Smile. Can you say something so that we can see you, sir?
Yeah, the footballing smile is and
hello, can you hear now?
Yeah.
Yeah, can you hear now?
Yes, sir. Yeah, because it's showing Del Ivy. Del, I couldn't see your name. Hello, ma'am. Yeah. Hello, ma'am. I'm glad you joined us, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, ma'am. So, good evening, everybody, and hearty welcome to my teacher, Professor Dr. Robinson Smile. Thank you very much, Dr. Smile, for accepting my invitation. And sir is an emeritus professor in Mahatma Gandhi Medical College and Research Institute in Pondicherry, after having retired from Jipmer Pondicherry. And sir, his name is Robinson Smile, and I have never seen him without a smile. So he's the very epitome of the word smile. And if there is one person whom I can attribute to my not becoming a surgeon, it is Dr. Smile, because I said if I cannot operate like him, I should not be a surgeon. So the credit of my not becoming a surgeon goes to sir. Sir, can you just take us through a little bit about your MBBS days, sir? Can you please unmute yourself, sir? Dr. Smile, can you please unmute yourself?
Sir, the left lower corner, there is an audio symbol. That just click on that.
There is a mic symbol, sir.
I Shastri here. I have a photo of Dr. Smile from 1960. Can I?
You can just show it there.
Show it there.
You can on your computer. Yes, you can.
Just share the screen. No problem.
You can share the
screen. It's on my desktop, actually.
Oh, yeah, wonderful. You can do that. Yeah. You can share it.
You can
it
do
now.
That. Please just share it now.
Give me a second.
Smile, sir. You have to unmute, sir. Because I'm not able to come here.
Speaker Sir, can you just unmute yourself, sir? There is a mic symbol on the left lower corner. Can you please unmute yourself, sir?
Just click on that and then it will be unmuted.
Okay, Radha Krishna, you just unmute everybody. We will, the rest of us will mute ourselves. Oh, we have a young friend helping us. Shastri, we are waiting for your picture.
Yeah, it's on my screen. I don't know, but just a second. I just need to, you know.
You just put, just click the share screen.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll just.
Hello, can you hear now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I can hear you.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Sir, please tell us something about your MBBS days, sir.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh.
Is that photo visible?
Yes, very nicely. Sir, can you see this old picture? Can you see this old picture of yourself, sir?
Yeah. Who has got projected this?
Me, Shastri.
Oh.
Here I am. I don't know if I'm visible.
I had a similar photo.
It's your photo, sir. I've stolen it.
Hello?
It's your photo, sir.
Okay. So Shastri, if you can just stop sharing for a brief
I'll do that.
Yeah, I know, I could recognize him.
Give me a second. I need to find out how to stop sharing this.
Hello?
The same thing. You just click the share screen and that you'll get the option.
Yeah. I'll do that. Yeah, just a second.
On
give
top,
me a second.
Yeah,
just
no
ignore
sir,
brief.
No worries. Sir, we just want to know something about your MBBS date, sir, Dr. Smile.
My MBBS date?
Yes, sir. How did you how did you decide to take up medicine and some story about your MBBS date, sir?
No, that is my father's influence only, of course. how I came to Pondicherry was a big story.
Because
when I was doing PUC, about five of us wanted to join medicine, my classmates. We had a psychology professor from Cuddalore, right?
Yes, sir.
So he told us to apply to Pondicherry Jipmer because it's a new college which is coming up. In fact, we had applied for Mother Tamil Nadu and Krishna Medical College, Vellore. So while waiting, I got admission here. Then I joined here. That is how I came here. Otherwise, I would have joined. Subsequently, I got from the waiting list Madurai. Then I decided not to go from here. I found this place more pleasant and better. So I joined here and continued.
So where was your childhood, then, sir?
Actually,
Chako.
Childhood was in Nagarkoil. Till my PUC, I was at Nagarkoil. My father was working in Mission Hospital, Nagarkoil. So subsequently, he was practicing. So while practicing only, I watched him, his practice, how he was doing. So, and he also wanted me, I was the youngest, and he wanted me to become a doctor. That's how I took up medicine. Then after joining here, things were very, very smooth. I found my girl. So that was more interesting.
So you need to tell us something about how you got together with Dr. Vijaya.
Yes, Vijaya, how he found the girl is a thing of interest.
That was the first year experiments, chemistry and zoology and all that. Because we used to be together. That is how it started. Right?
STUV, that's why, sir. Alphabetical, was it? How did you land up being together?
What about your motorbikes, Mike? You're not telling the Bullet 350.
Bullet was much later.
Oh.
This, we and Robinson Smile, because of the waiting list, we came from the waiting list. So I joined first and we came later. So that is how we were in the towards the end. So nice to see all of you.
Was your father also a surgeon, sir?
No, he was just a medical practitioner. He was an assistant in the Mission Hospital. So working there for a long time, and he was practicing at home.
So while you were doing...
Of course.
Yes, sir?
Yes.
No.
No, but exams and all that, you want to tell me about the exams? Exams are always difficult, you know.
Yes,
sir. I almost fail, you know. Every year I fail. I failed in physiology. Then I failed in pharmacology. Then I failed in medicine.
Oh my God.
Second attempts only. But the only thing is those days, but no regrets, because those days it used to be very difficult, you know. We had to go and appear in Madras along with the other students. So things were very difficult those days. So anyway, we made it in the second attempt finally. Then after passing MBBS only, my father got my bullet.
Ah, that was your gift for your passing MBBS, sir?
Yeah, passing.
So
it was the second attempt, father was quite happy only, so he bought me the bullet.
So did madam get the first ride on the bullet, sir?
Yes, definitely. And many more. Many others also got.
By what year were you kind of, did you know that you wanted to become a surgeon, sir? When you joined MBBS, by which year were you kind of sure that you wanted to do surgery?
Yeah, almost by second, third year itself, I sort of developed some interest in surgery, because we are staying along with our seniors for your final years. So those people, we used to go with them and see, some of them are, that time itself, house surgeons, they were doing surgery, they were talking about it. They have taken us inside the OT and all that. So one of them was Thomas Verghese. He was the first MS from our college. He alone joined first batch, he was the only one. Then he got his FRCS, now in Malaysia. He was a very close friend of mine because we were playing basketball together those days. So that's how I developed interest. Almost from third year, fourth year, I was very much wanted to do surgery. Then
we had
senior house surgeons. We had to do senior house surgeons in those days. That is after compulsory house surgeons. That if you want to take up surgery, then you'll have to do 6 months of posting in surgery. So those days it was very interesting. My seniors were so nice. We developed so much. We could do a lot of surgery that time itself. So that continued.
Were you very good at dissection and anatomy, sir?
Anatomy dissection I used to do well. In fact, the anatomy, our demonstrator was, I was staying with him, Dr. Benjamin. He is a plastic surgeon now in UK. So those days, hostel was very difficult. Only few can get into the hostel. Almost all of us were staying in different houses in Pondicherry, in different places. So I was staying with him. So because we knew him early, so he gave me the accommodation there. And he used to teach me also in the night, evening, any problem he used to always teach me a lot. So that way, I had a lot of help from many people.
So when did you and madam get married, sir? Before your surgery PG or after?
No, with me only, no?
Yes.
Got married with me. It was 1974.
So before you did surgery or after? That's what I want to
after, know. After. Okay. I didn't want to get married before that. Because surgery was my first. So after getting MS only, I got married.
So what did you want to do after completing your MS? At that point in time, what did you have in mind for your future?
After getting MS?
Yes, sir.
That itself was very difficult. MS itself was quite difficult. You know, I got in the third attempt only. So I didn't want to venture further and get into problems. I wanted to, just MS was sufficient for me those days.
Who were your teachers in MS general surgery? Who inspired you? Who taught you the real techniques in general surgery, sir?
Actually, the one who taught me the real surgery was Dr. Muralidhar, my just immediate senior PG. That was, he belonged to the second batch. I was the third batch MS in Chipmur. So I was with him in Unit 2 when Dr. Bodhi Raja, I think anybody will remember him or not. So he left around 72 or something, he left when Dr. Bodhi Raja. Murali was for me, everything. He used to be, he was a gold medalist from MMC. And he got seat in Madras Medical College, but still he wanted to do MS here and he came and joined. So I was under his guidance. He always used to help me in everything. And he patiently used to assist me. I would have done at least 10, 15 hernias. And every time I have a problem, he'll come and assist me throughout. And he was just quiet and never used to shout. Such a beautiful surgeon. He is now thoracic surgeon in Coimbatore. Naidu Hospital. He was my best friend and guide throughout. And of course, my teachers are Dr. Bodhi Raja, then Dr. Mejiratha, Dr. Sibal, and by the time Dr. Andhakrishna has joined, a lot of influence from him. Because I used to always envy him, the knowledge and the skill and everything he had, the teaching capacity. I used to envy him actually.
So, actually, I was going to ask you that question, you've said it yourself. The other thing is when I was in MBBS at that time when we were undergraduate, somehow you didn't seem to be so much interested in academics. But by the time I became a senior resident, I used to see you, really going out of your way to teach. So what made that transition, sir? Because when we were undergraduates, you used to hardly do any classes and all for us. But by the time I finished my MD and, then joined as senior resident, you were a very active teacher and very active in academics. So what made you change, sir?
Oh, academic after getting MS, I was sort of forced to teach students also. I had to teach, you know, I had to take classes for them. Then I used to read a little bit. That's why I said, no, the influence was mainly from Anandakrishnan. Because all the students used to say his clinics are very good and theory teaching lectures are very good. And we both of us supposed to take finally classes from 8 to 9 every day morning. So to make it up to some extent, no, I had to read, and that's how I picked up a little bit. Even now I'm trying.
it's the for the benefit of so many students that people like you and Dr. Anandakrishnan and all decided not to just retire and either stay at home or do private practice, but actually moved into another institute where you have been able to again train and guide another two generations of surgeons. So we are all extremely thankful to people like you and Dr. Anandakrishnan, sir, who decided to continue to teach even after retiring from government service. So there's a lot of talk about work-life balance these days. So somehow you always seem to be very, calm and relaxed. So what was your secret of work-life balance those days, sir?
Maybe by the influence from home itself, I would say. Then after coming here, the people who around me who influenced me. Then at home, about my father, I should say, because the way he practiced medicine those days. So those people come and ask him so many things. Yeah, so many things, even repeatedly asking them, even it's crowded, used to very quietly and very patiently telling them, helping them. Those things I used to see when I was in the school and PUC. Yeah, another one important thing I tell you, there was his patient, one man, he's in chronic asthmatic. So almost every month, one night, he'll come with severe attacks. Middle of the night only he'll come. See, when he gets the attack, he will never come. He'll wait till he becomes breathless. So in fact, when he's outside the house, in the street itself, I used to get up because of the noise. My father used to sleep the front room by the side of the window. The moment he hear that, immediately open, get him inside, give him a shot of adrenaline, sit with him for about an hour till he becomes all right, then send him home. It happens many times. In spite of that, he never used to scold him or why you are coming late and all that. Such things, a lot of things that influenced me. Then after coming here, of course, at home also, I don't make much noise. Then there was no need also. Then after the college and the hospital, a lot of people influenced me. I told you about Dr. Murali. He was such a nice man, very quiet, very patient. So I sort of observed from him, that's the way you have to be. And the third thing was, when I was house surgeon and finally a student, when you go to OT, there were a few surgeons who used to shout like anything. They will start from the skin incision itself. So the juniors and assistants, the moment he is coming to OT, means most of them will disappear. They come out and talk about him very badly. Then never used to assist them. So those sort of things I was wondering. So suppose you also start doing all this, nobody will like you and nobody will come to you also. No? Those sort of things. Then I thought it'll be good if you're quiet and while doing surgery especially. Because if you start shouting and if you get perturbed, it'll upset the others also. They also become nervous. Where we always shout when you are incapable, not able to manage the situation. Then only you become jittery and start shouting.
Yes, Shastri. Sir, the description you made of Dr. Murali, who you said you copied, is you, sir. You are describing yourself. And you were the one who taught me to be calm, never shout, and, you know, be friendly. And, you know, because there's no need, surgery is basically, you know, you're playing with lives and it can be stressful. And there's no point in taking that stress out on everybody around you. So thank you very much for teaching me that, sir.
So for those in LGS who may not be knowing all of us, sorry,
not audible.
We make it into almost like a JIPMA party. But this is Dr. Shastri, a very senior surgeon. And he used to take clinics for us when we were undergraduates. And he's in Bangalore. And he's really like at least 50% of doctors' minds in the being really quiet and calm while operating. So I fully understand when you say that you are influenced by him. Thanks, Shastri, for joining. And sir, you did mention about playing basketball. So did you continue with your sport even after you became a surgeon? Dr. Smiles, can
yeah,
you hear
me? Yeah, I continued till I finished my... Yeah. Can I hear now?
Yes, sir.
Now, I was continuing till I passed out, and even after that, I was playing for some time. But basketball was a little tiresome. So I was playing for the... We always used to have... Andhra Kishan will know. Every year, we used to have a staff-student match. We used to always participate in that. We had basketball, volleyball, cricket, and football. Even football, I was playing after that for some time. And after that, I changed to tennis. Now I am playing tennis only.
Vidya, can I say one thing?
Yeah, absolutely. So everyone, this is Dr. Punendra Roy, again another senior surgeon and an entrepreneur. He runs his own hospital and he does a lot of cutting edge surgery in Kolkata.
He's a movie maker.
Yeah. And, there is no industry left in which he doesn't have his foot inside. So rather unusual, Jipmarait. Thanks, Punendu, for joining.
There are no gallbladders left in the eastern part.
No, Punendu came here some time back. He was here for some time. That time we met. And...
Yeah, we. I thought in continuation of Shastri, because I am very tempted to talk to a lot of people. But today we are talking for Sir Dr. Smiles. And when he spoke about his calmness, just one short incident, he was doing a linorenal shunt. And the debakey clamp, the vascular clamp which he had put and he had opened the renal vein, the clamp had given up. The abdomen had filled up with blood. And any one of us would have screamed at the sister for giving a clamp which the ratchet was not holding. He went, he dipped his hand in the pool of blood, held the renal vein with his fingers and looked at the sister and said, should you not just give the clamp after checking? Please don't do this next time. This fellow will die. And I couldn't believe, I still remember the day that in that pool of blood with a clamp which did not hold the ratchet, so that leaked like that and he was so calm. And to continue with Shastri's statement, that if at all we wanted to learn, there are so many things other than surgical skill, other than blunt dissection, sharp dissection, the one which we always admired from Sir, that is Dr. Smile, is to remain calm, cool, and never to lose. Because I also had the honor of working with Professor Satya Prakash. So we have seen all kind of surgeries, and I've learned so much from Sir Ananta Krishnan, and he's always trying to tease me on something or the other, because I know how much he loves me. But Sir Dr. Smiles, sir, we have learned so much from you, not only surgery, but also how to develop a surgical personality. Thank you, sir.
Vidya, can we request Professor A.K. to share his days and the philosophy and what is special
about
him?
Thank you very much.
Can you start?
Thank you, Purnendo.
Sir, we'd like a little bit about the 40 years of friendship that you mentioned about, sir.
We want to know.
AK
Smiles' view
and of AK's view. And I'll hold my comments for the end.
As always.
After hearing what he says about me, then I will say.
Dr. Smile, this particular incident that Punendu describes, clearly shows that when you're competent and you're confident, then your the way you behave changes. So do you think that surgeons are born, you should have a natural ability, or do you really think that anyone, if they try hard enough and train hard enough, can be a surgeon? You must have seen all kinds of people who have trained under you or worked with you. So I want an honest statement, sir. Do you really think someone can be as good as you just by training?
He's not as good as me. He can be always better than me. No, there must be some aptitude first to develop that interest, to become a surgeon. Then you develop interest and you have to work hard, definitely. This surgery, I think you'll have to work very hard to develop that. You must have the interest and develop on that. Because I remember, again, working with Murali, our admission day used to be, always. I was always in unit 2, right? So we used to have OPD on Tuesday, emergency will be, throughout will be busy. And next day morning, throughout will be operating. Morning you'll have to come. And those days used to be the OT will be on the next day. So night along with the emergency, we make our list, get the patients ready for next day surgery and all that. And next day continuously operate till 2. Then go back to hostel. Then he was interested in cricket. I used to play football. So both of us will be in the field for till about 6:30. Come back. The hostel, we are staying in the same hostel. And then go back again to the hospital at 8 o'clock. See all the post-operative patients and all that. Come back. By the time it will be 9:30. Then next day will be a rounds day. Again, he'll start rounds by 8. So that used to be the regular surgical practice we had. So someone is not coming, not attending. There used to be some people, those who were left. So that type of work we'll have to do, hard work we'll have to do. Unless you see emergency patients, follow them up throughout till discharge. Otherwise, you don't learn anything. That time only you develop a lot of interest. So those type of cases and incidents and a lot of chances we had, that helped a lot in developing a lot of interest in surgery. So it is not only that you just want to become a surgeon, you'll have to put in a lot of hard work. Yeah, then only you can become really a good surgeon.
So Radha Krishna always teases me, and other anesthetists that how do we, when we have seen the same surgery being done beautifully in a short time by somebody else, and we see somebody else struggle for much longer and doing it badly, how do we, keep our cool or whatever? So that's nothing compared to, exceptional surgeon like you. How do you have the patience when you see somebody not doing that great a job? Okay, if it's a student, you know that you're going to train and teach and make them better. But suppose it's a colleague or somebody. So how do you have the patience to see a surgery which is not being done that well?
Not audible, Vidya.
Yeah. Vidya,
yeah.
There is a way to it. I will not mention the person, but to quote, I remember when I used to go to the OT, AK sir will always tell, go and watch Dr. X operate. So I used to go there and operate and watch and come back. So one day I could not resist my impatience and I asked AK sir that, why do you always ask me to go and watch X doing surgery? He said, because it's very important to learn how not to do surgery. So I call this a surgical attitude. There is so many things. There are many people who have said that I admired AK sir so much that I wanted to copy his behavioral pattern, literally walk like him, talk like him, develop a surgical attitude like him. I still remember he told, you must go and watch him every day. Will not mention the person, so that you learn how not to do surgery. So Vidya, I think it's very important to watch all kind of people. I used to go to gynae operation theater. I don't know whether you remember Professor Prabhavati.
Yes.
I've spent large number of hours in gynae because she was ambidextrous. There are many times I used to take the knife in left hand and try to see whether I can become ambidextrous. So you pick up so many things. One day AK, sir, actually, this is just recollecting the memories. I hope you people don't mind.
This session is only for that.
Okay. One day, SN Banerjee and me, we had taken a bet that we can finish a vagotomy GJ in 30 minutes. And we were racing through doing the second and third anastomosis of GJ. AK sir came to know about it. And he came and told us, never ever challenge for speed first surgery. Speed is not an. He wanted to ban us from entering in the OT. So many things we learned from him. And once he was doing a compound sigmoid volvulus, and that day he told me it was an emergency in the night. He said, now speed is important. Don't ask me any question. Don't ask stupid things. Just see when speed is required. And in no time, I realized that he had taken the ganglionus segments off. So each time, I think by observing several people and picking up different things from different people like we did, from Sir Smiles, from AK, and from others, that's how a complete surgeon can become, which we tried, maybe we are not. And that's why they're AK, and that's why they're Smiles, and we are just Shastri, Purnendu Roy, and others.
Dr. Smile, I want to ask you a question now. Sir, are you there?
Yeah.
Yes. Among all this galaxy of your students that you see today, I'm going to put you on the block by asking you, who was your favorite student and who do you think was the best surgeon among the lot? There are some 15, 20 of them here who have trained under you. It'll make their day if you...
What about the others?
All of them are good in their own field. Because they all left after they got their degree, you know.
Yeah, at that period, sir. Now they would have become different. I meant during the training period, whom did you spot as some real potential or, you know, you thought that person will go a long way or whatever. Everyone has done brilliantly. All of them are giants in the field and everything. But
when they were with me, they were all equal only. There were no difference at all.
Diplomatic. I think this unit system in JIPMA, the students didn't rotate through the other unit. So if one is working with one's professor unit, you are all the time with that professor. So not all of them went through the exposure with everybody.
So, sir, at this point, being an anesthetist, I have to ask you, because you were one of our favorite, as anesthetists, you were one of our favorite surgeons, because you were a pleasure to watch, you were fun, and you never used to get angry, and, you know, so many things. But do you think that it is important, the kind of relationship that you have with your anesthetist, does it influence how a surgery goes?
Yeah, I always believe that you must have a very close relationship with that. It is like a husband and wife. In fact, my chief's wife, Budharaja, and his wife, Prem Budharaja, she was anesthetist. So our OT time used to be very peaceful. You know how the morning itself, she'll tell, today you cannot operate beyond 2. Like that, you'll put conditions then come. So the OT will be over by that time. So he was very scared of his wife. I know you would not have seen him. My relationship with anesthesia, it's a very, very, very long relationship. It's a long story. I can tell you that. I told you about the senior house surgeon. The 6 months and rest of the 6 months he'll have to do an allied subject. Now what I took up was anesthesia. I was in anesthesia for nearly 5 months. In fact, after one, Dr. Verma, one senior professor was there that time. It was at other department. I used to do duty with him. He used to allow me to do cases alone sometimes. Section, obstructed hernia, those type of. So I developed a lot of interest. And the next thing is, important thing is, when I finished my registrar post, after there was no post to stay in Jipmer. So I had applied for a DGMO post. That's also UPSC. Okay. Then I got selected in that, but I was posted to Trichy Rockfort Hospital. So I had to leave. Then that time Dr. Mejratha was there. So I told him, sir, I got a posting in Trichy. I have to resign and go. Then he said, you write a letter and saying that you are already in Jipmer, a teaching institute. You want to continue here. So my post may be transferred here. So actually he himself took the letter to Delhi, because he knew people there in Delhi, and got me transferred to Jipmer. So when that letter came to Jipmer, the GDMO post is, he can be posted anywhere. So that time surgery, there was no GDMO post. Already there, faculty, lecturers, assistant professors and all that. So there was a vacancy in anesthesia. So I was posted in anesthesia. So that time, Dr. Kangle was there, head of the department. I don't know, you remember her?
Yes, sir. My boss.
Yeah. She was there. Then I talked to her, because those days we used to be very friendly with even head of the department of anesthesia. So I told her, I requested her. Then she said, you can continue in surgery. But my pay and all that used to come in the anesthesia register. That's how I continued in surgery. Big help she gave. Then subsequently, of course, Ravi and all that came, and we developed a close relationship with Ravi. And he is still with us a long time. That is how...
You must have worked a lot with Dr. L.J. Chandrasekhar also, right, sir? Chandrasekhar LJ?
Yeah. That actually, he stayed for a very short period. He would have stayed there for till his registrar post, about his PG and registrar. Then after that, he left. Most of the time, Ravi was there. Even though we have a 6 year difference, we develop a very close relationship. That is how it. So, any party in anesthesia, even in Jipmer, even now, I was always invited. Even we have had many parties in Dr. Kangle's house. So that used to be the thing. That's how my relationship with anesthesia was.
She remembers you very fondly, sir.
She
remembers you very fondly. There are a lot of people who are
The another point also, I'll tell you, that time Dr. Chakravarti was there. Remember, associate professor?
I have heard of him, sir. Chakravarti Memorial Oration we have.
Yeah. And my PG dissertation was an experimental surgery and dog, that is uretroureteric anastomosis. That is, we anesthetize a dog, open up and cut the ureter one side, ligate it, leave it, and after 3 weeks, go back again, open, do and reconstruction. My boss Budharaja was a urologist, so he was interested in that. So to start with, nobody has done experimental surgery before that. So to give anesthesia, I had to ask some anesthetists. So when I went to the department, Dr. Chakravarti was so kind enough. So though he was a senior professor, he said he'll come. So he used to come with me in the afternoon to Animal House. So he used to give anesthesia for that. I used to operate. For a few dogs, he gave anesthesia. Subsequently, we learned and we used to do it. So that is how my relationship with the anesthesia department.
So there are a whole lot of your students who are waiting to talk to you, sir. Vimal is the professor of surgery in Coimbatore. Vimal, would you like to say a few words?
Yes. Yeah, hi.
Vimal was my first to be.
Good evening, sir. Nice to see you.
Good evening. Nice to see you.
And good evening, AK sir. Exactly. I'm happy honor of being your first student. In fact, a few years ago at a conference, I met two people who were your postgraduates, one 10 years my junior and the other one 20 years my junior, together three of us. I don't remember the names, but generation of surgeons. And it was a privilege to be your first graduate. What I would like to say is, you know, the time that we spent in the unit with you, you may have been a faculty, but you were more like one of the residents. You know, you were so approachable, you know, move around with you like we could. The theater day really look, you would bring and we would sit and gobble up all your while you had our half MS lunch. And I would like to mention one particular incident. We posted.
Well, your voice is breaking.
She didn't want Tali removed. Am I audible?
Your voice is breaking a little bit.
Okay. Maybe because I'm excited. Okay.
It's a wavelength problem.
I was going to incident. We had an old lady. Posted for some surgery, Tali to be removed. And you know how anesthetists are with they from a body before we are in.
Vimal, we are not able to make out.
Vimal, can I suggest something? You just stop your video. You may have better bandwidth. Just stop your video and speak.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Is it better now?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Better now.
Okay, running the risk of repeating myself. Talking about that old lady who was posted for a surgery who didn't want her thali to be removed, and the anesthetist insisted that we remove every piece of metal from our body before we wheel her in. So sir spoke to the anesthetist and said, see, you get her under and then we'll remove the thali. And after the surgery, you know, he wasn't the one who was operating, but he made sure that before she is extubated, we put the thali back on. So that's some of these incidents remain firmly etched in my memory. And some of these things, I wish I could I wish I could operate like he did. But these are some of the things that I have, I certainly remember from my postgraduate days. Yes, sir.
The relationship between those days with the senior and junior, that is because of the age. Age difference is not much, you know. So we all used to be together. I told you, Ravishankar is 6 years junior to me, but still used to be together. Nowadays, if you are senior and the juniors are very hesitant to come and talk to you, they are a little scared. They don't come and, even though we want them to come and talk to us, they don't come. Then they're always there. They are also convenient. We are also quite easy to move with them. That is one thing you must remember that.
More of Pandit Tandi. Once they consume good Pandit Tandi, the inhibitions of talking will go.
Yeah.
That's what used to happen in the weekend in Hawaii also, no?
So we are talking about seniors and juniors. So from your first postgraduate, Vimal, I'd like to go to a little more junior person, Deepak Dubey. Deepak, are you there? Can you unmute yourself and speak? Deepak is a urologist in Manipal Hospital in Bangalore, and he does. He's been doing laparoscopic donor nephrectomy for years. Long before it became not the norm. Deepak, would you like to say something?
Yeah, certainly, Vidya.
Deepak Dubey is not very junior. Yes, then quite some time back. Now he has become a senior consultant. No.
So it's really really delightful to be here with Professor Anand Krishnan and Dr. Smiles and so many of my seniors and my batchmates. I can see them. It's a wonderful effort, Vidya, that you brought us all together. I was in Dr. Smiles' unit and I had the best of the time over there. you know, people have said lots of things about his skills, about his calmness. So I will not repeat all of that. So he has been very, very influential in my life for many ways, because I have tried to model myself on his surgical skills, and that has really been helpful to me. Aside from that, he has had a very important influence, and I will narrate that. So till the time I joined his unit in MS, I was a complete teetotaler. So one of the parties that we had, our unit parties, which were very regular. So he came up to me seeing that I was not holding a glass. And then he asked me, you know, why don't you have something? So I said, sir, I feel that, you know, if you're a surgeon, it's not good to drink because you may, you know, your hands may tremble. He said, no, that's not the way. Just have a little, and then your hands will be very steady. So that was the day I was introduced to having a good drink. And you know, the time we spent in his unit was very fruitful, tremendous learning, all his attributes of great surgical skills, his calmness, his you know, stability while dealing with critical situations has had a lot of influence on all of us, and we are very thankful that we were able to train under him. Thank you very much, sir, and thank you, Vidya, for arranging this wonderful meeting.
Thanks, Deepak. And now, all the way from US, early in the morning, my classmate Chako is waiting for his turn to speak. Chako, are you there?
Yeah, by the way, whose photograph is that?
You want to know who has shared it, sir?
Sir, that's me, Dr. Shastri. I've shared it.
Shastri.
Yeah. Shastri, yeah? Oh.
Yeah.
Shastri, can we see you with hair there?
Yeah, that's right. That's a little, you know, obviously there's some balding already there. I'm sitting next to Dr. Mehta. And then there's Kulbushan Bahl. And of course, Sir's there. And Dinkar Pai is there.
Yeah.
And of course, the Thandi, sir. That's why I put it up. Thandi, that was absolutely necessary.
Is that Narasimhan next to Dr. Smile?
Yes, it is Narasimhan. Yeah, okay. Correct.
I remember the story of Shastri's loss of hair. When I first met him in England, somebody told him, Shastri, you lost all your hair. He says, it's a wrong word. Lost is something when you don't know where it is. I know where all my hair, because every time I took bath in the bathtub in this English quarters, which were provided by NHS, half of my hair will go. It's all there in the bathtub. I can go and collect it whenever I want. So this was the typical sense of wit which Shastri always had.
Thank you, Shastri, for bringing back all those nice memories. Chako, would you like to say something? Please unmute yourself. Chako is a urologist. Chako is a urologist
in
Florida.
Hi, Chako.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
Yes, sir. Good morning. It's quite early morning here. I recognize a lot of people on the screen, but some of us suffer from the ravages of time. I was in Dr. Smile's unit from 86 to 89. Dr. Sybil was there. I have fond memories of all everyday rounds. And, you know, one thing about him is learning by example. He doesn't speak a lot. Unlike me, I always had to look at him because he's always telling you and not saying much. I have to follow his steps, and I didn't know. I still adopt a lot of what you do without speaking. So nurses ask me, what do you do? Okay, this is what I want you to do, but you observe me. So even students tell me, you don't speak a lot. When I operate, I follow his example. They say, what did you want? You see, you follow me. Otherwise, it's been a wonderful experience. Sharing, decision making is excellent. In decision making, style and substance, quiet power. He had influence over everyone, including Dr. Sybil. Ask him. He'll always say, ask him. Dr. Sybil will make two long rounds, I think twice a week. It'll be like 3 p.m., 4 p.m. Say, Dr. Sybil, what do you want to ask him? He will do. So after the rounds, we'll go and have a bonda or whatever. Between 4 and 6, we'll post all the cases, and you know, And if it's an operating day, we'll have a lunch together. He'll bring all his food and we'll share it up. And he won't say a lot, but he'll quietly, you know, whether it's a difficult case or big case or complication, perfect silence. So I think I picked up on it. I'm not by nature a quiet person. And a lot of other surgeons talk a lot, but I just keep my cool. And I think I learned from you, sir, and thank you for it. Even here, a lot of people want to be in my room because I don't shout. I do make some comments. I think I learned from Dr. Ananda Krishnan. One-liners. I'll just drop it and move. Then they know, what did he say? So, but things get done. So surgeons don't have a lot of time. So I just make it known that, hey, if you don't cooperate with me, you know, I'm just going to walk out. I really don't want to put up. I don't have a lot of time. So they understand that. So, you know, you got to get people in line to work for all of us. Anesthesia are my favorites. I think our batchmates, a lot of them are favorites. So I get pronounced Manoj, you, Mota, I mean, Sina, I guess. You are, sometimes you'll ask me to do the spinal, let me have my dinner. So I don't know, Dr. Kangle, no or not. We used to do our own spinal sometimes. Because he said, I need to have my dinner. I just had a soccer match and, you know, I'm tired. I said, okay, let me do this stuff and you have your dinner. I don't know if you recall that we should say this, but yeah, I enjoy my time. I think one form of flattery is you absorb what they do quietly, and that's a good compliment to you, sir. And Dr. Ananda Krishnan too, I think he wasn't happy that I didn't go to his unit because I was his intern for a year. And I mean, surgical rotation, I learned a lot from him, but when unit Dr. Minocha came, it all got jumbled up, and I think even to another unit, I came to unit one, and I ended up with Dr. Sybil and Dr. Smile, which I enjoyed, but Dr. Andagisha never forgave me for it, I think. I don't know, whatever it is, I'll end it here. I really, truly enjoyed my stay there. A lot of the colleagues and the camaraderie, the nurses, the colleagues, anesthesia colleagues, and juniors, seniors. Dr. Wamsi is there. He should know me. I put him through a lot of trouble. That was a strict, but quite strict, I hope. I learned from Dr. Smiles. And I occasionally use Dr. Ananda Krishnan's method, which is one-liners. And drop it and leave. And it works. You come across, you know, you're better to be, I think as Muhammad Ali said, it's better to be respected than be liked. Sometimes you just, you know, say what you want and see if they cooperate. And many times, 99%, I get my way. So, you know, I'm fighting for patients and it gets my way. Dr. Smiles is a quiet, soft power. And I also wins. I think I acquired a lot of those qualities even now. And the post-operative outcome, pre-operative preparation, these are excellent people. And I think that's what the problem is in the U.S. right now. We don't have surgeons who have trained in pre-op, post-op, which is equally important, if not more. All right, I'll stop here. I'm very glad to be with all of you, and I'll continue to listen. Thank you.
Yeah, we have a young surgeon.
Nice to see you, Chaco. Very nice to see you, Chaco. And meet you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
We have a young person, Abhilash, who seems to be waiting in his PPE. So I think, Abhilash, would you like to say something? You don't look very comfortable in that. So
yes, I'm glad I worked under him. I was not in his unit, but
Abhilash, would you just introduce yourself? Because most of us don't know you. Because
I am Dr. Abhilash. I was his PG. I'm a general surgeon. I worked under him in Mahatma Gandhi Medical College. To talk about Robinson Smiles, sir, is like you have to go on for days or years to speak about him. And I always find it hard to believe that how much knowledge they had, especially Robinson Smiles, sir, as well as Ananda Krishnan, sir. You talk about any topic, any subject, and they'll be coming out with beautiful answers, and they were very well-knowledged and skill-wise also. we used to say, if you want to learn surgery as an art, you have to learn from Smile sir. If you want to learn surgery as a science, you have to learn from Anandakishan sir. That's how it was. And he was always, as previously seniors mentioned, both were easily approachable. They were very humble. It is very hard to find people who are so much skillful yet be very humble. I'm glad and I'm very thankful that we worked under both of these legends.
Thank you, Abhilash. Thank you for joining, though you are at work.
Yes,
and, ma'am. Dr. Smile and Dr. Anandakishan have not just inspired surgeons, they have inspired a generation of students. And here we have the head of the Department of Anatomy, Dr. Virendra Kumar Nim, my classmate. Nim, would you like to say something? Nim, would you like to unmute yourself and say something? Okay, we will get back to him. So my classmate Ramesh Babu is here with us. Dr. Smile, many of your students seem to have become urologists. Is there any reason for that? Maybe Ramesh will throw some light on it. Ramesh, can you unmute yourself?
I am here. I am Ramesh Babu. Sir, this is very nice. I am very happy to see you. Dr. Smiles, Dr. Anandakishan, after such a long time. And I am seeing my friends Vamsi and other people who are with me at JIPMER. The art of science, art of surgery was introduced to me in JIPMER. And it was a very, very... Because if you learn you don't have to learn surgery, you have to deal with people. The service you provide in JIPMER, the care we take, it is extraordinary. And surgery comes next. And the care, how to behave with patients was where we were into all JIPMER should be proud that we were introduced to the best of patients' care at JIPMER. Now that private, then when we came outside, we never knew about the government service. We were not introduced to the outside world at all. That was a negative point. But still, every one of us is doing well because of what we learned at JIPMER with great people like Dr. Anandakishan and Dr. Smiles. Urology, when I decided to do urology, it was you, sir, Dr. Anandakishan, who asked me to go and meet Dr. Ganesh Gopalakrishnan at CMC Vellore. I continued there. I worked there for a few months. And I am now here. It's very, very grateful to all of you. And it's very nice to see all my friends again. Thank you, Vidya, for the arrangements you have made. Thank you.
Thank you, Ramesh.
Yes.
We have another dynamic student of yours and Dr. AKS, Mohan Vamsi, who is the managing director of his Omega's hospital. Vamsi, would you like to say something?
Yeah, thank you so much, Dr. Vidya, for inviting me to join.
Vamsi, good evening. Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Very nice meeting you. Very nice seeing you all.
Yeah. Yeah, 12 years back, you know, when he came to Pondi for.
Yes, sir. I came to demonstrate.
Any conference, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm very happy, sir, to be here, to be sharing my experience. I saw Dr. Vimal, Dr. John Thomas Chako, and Dr. Saitan Singh was there in our unit that time, 1 year senior to us. Thomas Chako and Shaitan Singh. I can't see you all. Hello, Dr. Chako. I'm very happy to see you, all of you. Dr. Vimal was our senior resident. He taught us.
You can use the gallery view, Vamsi. You'll be able to see everyone. Use the gallery view.
Oh, I didn't know about this. Okay. Good. Anyhow, I'm very happy to be here at this meeting. We've learned surgery. I worked with Dr. Sibal and Dr. Smile. As Dr. Chako said, Dr. Sibal's rounds, the teaching rounds from morning 8 to evening 3, and the next day, Dr. Surgery. Dr. Sibal used to do good surgeries, and then Dr. Smile used to operate on most of the difficult cases, and it was a pleasure watching them, learning from them. And then as a senior resident, I worked under Dr. Anandakishan, so I had the opportunity to watch him, to learn from him. As Dr. Punyendu put it, we never switched our units those days. All 3 years we were in the same unit. So I was fortunate as a senior resident, I worked under Dr. AK. It was a pleasure watching Dr. Smiles. And I can tell you, even now, I haven't watched anybody doing such beautiful surgery. It's like a painter painting, you know. It's like, you know, it's not, it's an inborn talent. You can't learn that. God has given him that gift, both of them, Dr. Anandakrishnan and Dr. Smail. God has given them a gift. You know, you can't learn, you can't emulate him. We try, but we, of course, we never succeed. I'm very happy to be here. After leaving Chikmagalur, I settled down in Hyderabad in private practice. I was doing quite a bit of laparoscopic surgery. That's how I met Dr. Smail when they invited me to do lap Vardhem cystectomy in Chikmagalur, Pondicherry. I'm grateful to you all, sir. Grateful to you, Professor Sibal, Dr. Professor Mehta, Professor Anandakrishnan, Professor Srinivasan, Professor Jagdish, and Professor Smiles, of course, was my guide. Me and Muthayan were his students. Dr. Muthayan were there. We were in his unit. He was my guide. I'm grateful to you, sir, for teaching us surgery, for all of you, of course, all our teachers. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Dr. Vidya and Dr. Radhakrishna, for inviting me to join this. I missed last meeting. I didn't know how Zoom app looked like. I had to learn today to join this. I missed Dr. Anandakrishnan's. I saw that when you sent me the video. Thank you so much, Dr. Vidya.
You're welcome, Amsi. It was nice to have you.
Thank you. Nice seeing you.
You're in scrub, so I presume that you have a patient waiting in the operation theater. Is that it?
No, it's okay. Yeah, it's okay. I'll be here for this.
Okay.
It's a pleasure seeing all my seniors, Dr. Purnendu, Dr. Vimal. Dr. Vimal, you know, Jipmer was a different tradition. Dr. Vimal came as NAPH principal in examiner to our hospital. Then I called him sir and all. Then Vimal told me, you never called me sir in Chikmagalur. Why are you calling me sir here? You never called me sir in Chikmagalur. Why are you calling me sir now? So I said,
That is for the NABH certificate that you wanted.
No. No, see, we are in the private practice now. We are in this. We call everybody madam and sir.
Actually, Vimal was also our SAFI inspector, and I kind of recognized him, but he, you know, just squinted and looked at me for a while, and then finally I said, you know what, I'm Vidya, I was your junior in Jipma, and then he said, oh yeah, like, so yeah, he's gone as inspector to a lot of places.
I've got Alzheimer's with you.
we have many eminent non-surgeons also today in our guest list, and I'd like to welcome Dr. Bharati Dalla, who's a radiologist, and she was one of the first ones to start radiology services in the private sector in Chennai. Dr. Bharati, would you like to say something?
Yes, Vidya, definitely. Fond memories.
Before that, I want to.
Smiles, how are you?
I was a small girl when I joined Japan. I was running around there.
Details, yes. It was so nice to see you, sir. And Dr. Anandakrishnan, sir, very good to see you too. How are you all doing? All well? Yeah, you know what? I worked as we used to call junior house agency those days, rotatory internship. I worked with in Dr. Medhiratha's unit. So I worked with Dr. It was the most fun posting that I have ever known in my life. I tell you, that was the best couple of months that I spent in Jipma was in Dr. Medhiratha's unit with this wonderful group. And Dr. Smiles, of course, was the guiding spirit there. Dr. Medhiratha was very senior, so you know, but even then, and I was the only, I think there were about 18 men in that unit, and I was the only female posted there. And they made it so much of fun for me because all of them knew that I was not going to do surgery ultimately, but I had a really good time. And like, I've not been a student of Dr. Smiles in surgery, but in etiquette, in bedside manners, in pleasantness and everything, I have learned a lot from you, sir, definitely. And like you said, I have known you since my childhood, but I really enjoyed those few months that I worked with you in surgery. I worked with Dr. Anandakrishnan for a very short time during my senior house agency. Sir, you were a real terror and I was so scared of you at that time. You know, he was not married at that time. And then after I finished my posting, soon after he got married, and then everybody told me he's mellowed down after the marriage. But unfortunately, I missed that, you know. But then subsequently, I've met him a few times subsequently after I became a radiologist, and I had very good interactions with him. But my surgical posting in Medirata's unit was the most amazing time I have had. I cannot even describe it to you. I think, Dr. Smiles, you remember that group, you, Leons, Joseph, Lokur Raja, and so many others. I had a wonderful time. So thank you. Thanks to you and your team. Thank you so much. And, you know, I learned so much of how to become a clinical radiologist because I watched all of you doing surgery, and it fascinated me, the anatomy that you would display. So when I used to see it in my 2D and 3D images on screen, I really learned how to be a clinical radiologist rather than just someone who reads images, mechanically. So thank you for that too. Thank you.
Bharti, I became mellowed because my wife's name is Shanti.
That's what I said. You mellowed after marriage, sir.
Which year was this? Which year? We can't recollect some of it.
Let me introduce myself first. I was the batch of 1970, okay? So I did my rotatory internship in 1976. At that time, I was with Dr. Smiles. In 1977, I had just got married, and then I joined radiology. And as part of the rotation in radiology, we were asked to do 3 months of surgery. And I did, and by option, I did 3 months of anesthesia. And I really loved anesthesia too, but you know, it was too, it was very demanding, and I actually wanted a slightly easier life, I guess, so I went into radiology. But that surgical posting at that time was under Dr. Anantakrishnan. I don't remember the unit or who was the chief, sir, Dr. Satyaprakash?
Satyaprakash.
And of course, Satyaprakash was a different level altogether. I was scared of him. But Dr. Anantakrishnan was such an amazing teacher, but I was totally terrified of you, sir, at that time, honestly. But like I said, all of you are such legends. It was really wonderful working with all of you. So I think, yeah, 1976.
I think Dr. Anantakrishnan got married in 1975 or 76. He was unmarried when he came.
Oh, no, 77. No, when did you get married, sir? 79. I told you. After my posting, 70. I remember very well.
77, he joined Jipmer, I think.
Yeah, he had just joined and I got posted there. I was so scared of him, I tell you.
Were you, Dr. Bharti, were you the one who coined the word AK-47? Was it you?
I wish I had thought of that. Not really. No, he was such a stickler for, discipline and to do the right thing at the right time. So we're always, felt like little kids trying to please the boss. That's all. Nothing otherwise. He was a great, great guy, honestly. And that's about it.
Still a great guy.
Yes. And it's so it's so nice to see the others too. You know, Dr. Nalini, Dr. Who else is there? Seniors, or some of them are still there. Dr. Unnikrishnan, how are you? And Dr. Shastri, you are 2 years junior to me, I think, right? We had good times though those days.
Yeah, I meet Jaggi. Sorry, no private conversations. I meet Jaggi regularly, you know, in your class.
No worries.
Unni is there for a long time. He's one of our early postgraduates after I joined.
Dr. Unnikrishnan, would you like to unmute yourself and speak? Please unmute yourself, sir. Dr. Unnikrishnan, please unmute yourself. You're muted. Dr. Unnikrishnan, we can't hear you. You need to unmute yourself.
I think it should be the top right corner of your own, screen.
No, bottom left.
Okay, it must be different operating systems, I guess. So,
yeah. Shastri used to call somebody called OPD, Old Prince's Daughter, when we joined in. Do you have any memory of that?
I have photos.
That was me, yeah.
Oh, right. That's why I was, because when we joined in first year.
Which year did you join?
We joined 76.
Okay, yeah, I was still there at that time. Yes, that was me, right. So, that was a tag that I had to go throughout with my through my career in JIPMA. I tell you, that was the most distressing thing. What? We called the prince's daughter. I just hated it.
No, but we knew. Doctor
Unnikrishnan is. Let's listen to Doctor Unnikrishnan.
Yeah, I'm sorry to have got delayed myself. You know, that was not working. Something came, and then I could get on unmuting. So, my name is Dr. Unnikrishnan. I belong to Thrissur, Kerala, and belongs to 1968 MBBS batch. Did my MS in Continuum and left at in 79. No, I think I have been listening. Actually, this 1.5 hours, I am in JIPMA campus. I am not in Trivandrum.
So, can you lower your screen, sir? We can see your face completely. You can see half the face.
Okay.
Just adjust your screen, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yeah,
now yes, enough, sir.
Yeah, fine. Okay. Fantastic.
So, actually, I was in JIPMA campus for, you know, 1.5 hours. I was just waiting and listening. Nice to meet all of you. And Dr. Smiles, you know, a man with always smiles. And as somebody rightly said, he showed us the art of surgery. And Dr. Anandakrishnan had joined in 77 in our final year. And going through the surgical posting 3 years, to tell you frankly, we didn't know much about the stress of surgery because we're so always supported by our seniors. And I think my internship was with Dr. Smiles, Dr. Mahidiratta. Then my MS was with Sibel and Dr. Chowdhury. Both of them were in the third unit. And all these people whom you are mentioning, except the last 20 years who got trained, I'm aware. I can listen to like Dr. Budharaja, Dr. Satyaprakash. Nice to see. I mean, Vidya, I have not met you. Anyway, nice to meet you here. And thereafter, I came to Sri Chitra Institute. See, JIPMA is such a fantastic place. The foundation of a doctor is made there. I had a very smooth transition and a legend to train me in cardiovascular surgery. Dr. M.S. Valiyathan is Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. And we have the Chitra valve. But at some stage, I came over to vascular surgery. And I think my video is seen?
Yes, we can see you.
I think it has been a fantastic journey. Passionate and very happy to be in vascular surgery. And fortunately, with the JIPMA and Sri Chitra and our society, I've got the BC Roy Award in 2016. Now I am president of Vascular Society of India 19 to 21. I think all because of fantastic foundation, amazing people, and that's a campus. There's no campus like that, like JIPMA, anywhere in the world. And Dr. Mehta, Dr. Mehdi, yeah, so we have had fantastic people. It is like a Gurukula life. It was not like a stressful time. I don't think I've had much stress. And in vascular surgery, because I had started MCH vascular surgery first time in the country nationwide. So last 25 years, 30 years, it was stressful. But towards the last 10 years, it was enjoyable because we've done number of procedures, number of times. So Smile sir and AK sir, cannot thank you enough for making us what we are today. And thank you, Dr. Vidya, to have not personally invited, but the invitation was open in the Facebook. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for joining. I joined MBBS in 1980, so I had no way of knowing you. Sorry to have missed you out.
No problem.
Thanks for coming anyway. Another student of yours, Dr. Smile, Kulwant Singh, would you like to say something? Kulwant refused to tell me what he's doing now. So, Kulwant, you'll have to tell everyone what you're doing now. Please unmute yourself, Kulwant. Kulwant, unmute yourself, please. Yeah.
Yes. That's right?
Yeah, good.
I'm audible?
Yes,
you are.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're not recognizable, that's all.
That's why I told in the beginning I'm without my turban. Okay, and right now I just locked down and retired 4.5 years back and settled in Greater Noida, and I was working in a private hospital as a general surgeon. And very nice to see all my seniors, all my teachers, Dr. Smiles, Dr. Anand Krishnan, and Dr. Panindu, Dr. Shastri, and others who I've not met, but I heard their names, like Dr. Radhakrishnan, and Vimal is also there, my class fellow. So, hi everybody, good evening, Vanakam.
And Shastri Akal.
And Shastri Akal. And who was this? Shastri, me.
Dr. Anandakrishnan, who else did you think will give a one-liner or one
word
like that?
Oh, yes. One-liners, I very much remember his one-liners. So, really very nice. Really missed Zipmer very much. And it's not only a great institute, and every teacher, Dr. Smiles, Dr. Anandakrishnan, they then have an institute and then it's, so I've learned a lot from them, being from their clinical acumen, from their theoretical knowledge, surgical knowledge, their attitude, their discipline, punctuality, and of course the surgical skills, punctuality and other things like from Dr. Anand Krishna. So I've been trying to imbibe all those qualities which I have learned from my stay at Jipma, and by observing them and by listening to them, by assisting them.
Man, tu kya speech likh ke laya kya?
Oh, nahi yaar.
Punindu, he's a man of leisure now. He's retired. He's a man of leisure.
It's not written speech, man.
Let's all try and recollect some funny incidents of Jipma.
Yeah. So while Kulwan thinks up of something funny to recollect, can we have Piyush?
Yeah. I very much remember the one instance after I got my MS. Yeah. So people wanted to have a party. Okay, then R.K. Radhakrishnan, he said, we are not going to go to Aristo. We'll go to Harvey rooftop. So you arrange two gin and lime cordial, and rest will be arranged by us. And I think Purnendu would remember that there was Dr. Madan Mohan. He was senior resident. So he made the peg for everybody, and it was bottoms up. And there was Dr. Sashi, and he just went out of his clothes. So, Panindu, you remember that?
Panindu, I do remember.
SN Banerjee, then Ramachandran, V. Ramachandran.
Chandru was here as well.
Chandru was there. So he was the only person who was not drunk. Then he escorted me to my room.
I can tell one incident to Anandakrishnan, sir. One such incident we had on Harvey rooftop. We decided that we shall all have one peg from a new glass. So we had arranged for 20 glasses, and each one drank one glass and threw it into our principal, that time Dr. Ghosh, in the garden from the Harvey house. So next morning, there were about 25 or 30 glasses on principal's garden.
Good Lord. Sir, AK sir, was it your idea? Piyush is here from Coimbatore. He's your contemporary Kulwant and others. Would you like to say something, Piyush?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, hi, Piyush.
Hi. I see a lot of old faces after very long.
Hi, Piyush.
Hi. Shastri, I couldn't recognize myself, actually.
I see my grandfather in the mirror every morning.
Now, since this is about SMILES, the meeting, when I joined undergraduate JIPMER, I was in the Osler House, and we used to see this man promptly at 7:50 going in his motorbike in the road between Lister and Osler. It was something that it was so punctual always, and which will be followed or before him, LJ's turquoise colored scooter will go by. So, you know, they were so, so unbelievably punctual. But then I became very friendly with him during my football days, because he used to run, he was very active in the Spandan activity and things like that. And of course, in anesthesia. But the one thing that I have to tell you about him is that although his calmness, everyone knows his, you know, his absolute calmness under duress, everyone knows. But he was very friendly with everyone. The fellow who, you know, brings the C-arm will first wish him. You know, a fellow cleaning the theater in between cases, if he goes and says, Shigram Panapa, it'll be done. So he was friendly with everyone from top to bottom. That's something that I've always tried to emulate. And it's something that everyone should learn, actually. And in fact, I remember when a professor came briefly to JIPMER, and Dr. Smiles was scrubbing for some real major case. And I still remember him asking us, PGs, he's going to do that case? We said, yes, you just see how he does the case. So that way, the meeting everyone and treating everybody the same, it was unbelievable. And he was friendly with everyone. And the way he used to, you know, during Spandan, there were a lot of sticky spots, fights, everything. He used to calmly, the same way like he used to do his surgery, he used to sort that problem also out. And never have I seen him raise his voice. You know, sometimes you think, you know, are you real? How can you be like this?
For 12 years, I waited to hear him just raise his voice. Yeah. Never.
It's unreal, actually. It's unreal. I haven't seen AK, of course. Sometimes he does get angry, and it's normal to get angry, you know. So, but Smiles was unbelievable. And we are still waiting for him to get angry, you know. But his calmness was fantastic, and a lovely man, real lovely man. I do meet him quite regularly. In fact, I sent you there's a photo you got, I think.
Yeah.
Vidya.
Thanks for that, Piyush.
Yeah, that Angeline. Angeline took us, and guess where I met him? At the tennis court, in the police grounds. Yeah.
Piyush, you remember our football days?
Yes. I
Piyush?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yeah, tell me, I can hear you. This was around 3 years ago.
Yeah, remember our football?
Yes.
Yeah, this was about 3 years. Three years ago,
you were playing. You finished playing, and you know, Pondicherry is very funny. You know, when you go to meet Smiles, he was playing with the Chief Minister of Pondicherry. You know. You know, so, and I believe he used to play every evening.
Is that Manika Vasagar?
Yes, it is Manika Vasagan. Still trying to open his eyes. And I do meet. I met Dr. Veliath. I met him, and but AK had already wasn't there that time. But these three people and Shashi, I always meet. But I haven't come there for quite some time. But as
which,
I said,
which Shashi? Piyush, which Shashi you're talking?
Shashindran.
Shashindran.
Pharmacology. Okay. And he was friendly with everyone. Absolutely, Smiles was friendly with everyone. Unbelievable. And we are still waiting to, Vidya, if you hear any reports of him getting angry, please report to all of us. Good to see you all. Very good gathering.
Now there is no way to get angry.
Vidya, Sri Kumar, Giridhar, they're all waiting.
Dr. Nalini has been with us through all our programs till date, from Dr. Asha, Dr. Venka. Dr. Nalini, would you like to say a few words, medical, non-surgical perspective of Dr. Smile? Maybe she just stepped out somewhere. Chandru is here with us all the way from US. Good morning, Chandru. Would you like to say something? Chandru is a pediatric surgeon, and he does pediatric general surgery and transplant surgery. He did think about relocating to India, but decided not to. So he's always, accepted my invitations. And thanks, Chandru, for joining.
Hey, I just wanted to, can you hear me all right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I just wanted to say everything that people have said about how calm he was. But one of the things I wanted to actually repeat what S.N. Banerjee told me. It was one of those days where he was a senior resident, and he had always done the APR with Miles, and he said everything went so smooth. But the first time he did it alone, Smiles was not there or something in Jipmer itself, he said it was so difficult. I just realized how much he had been helping me without actually looking like he was helping me. So I think that understanding the planes and knowing exactly when to dissect, he was a master in all that.
I want to disclose something about Chandru. That me and Chandru was assisting Professor Satyaprakash for a major case which was about to take place for 6 or 8 hours. In Tamil, he told the sister to remove the stool from behind and said, "Na ipo faint panna poringla." So he planned a fainting, and he just fainted within 10 minutes of starting of the surgery. And I was telling everybody that he hasn't fainted, he planned it. I don't know whether Chandru remembers that. And then gradually it became a competition. Who can faint first? Because whoever can faint first can get out of the operation for the next 8 hours.
Oh my God. No.
If I may just...
I remember Dr. R.B. Mehta telling me that I'll never make a surgeon because I faint and I don't drink. So
you proved them wrong, Chandru. I heard you telling how you have done liver resection and all just with one nurse without even an assistant. So obviously, you've come a long way since your painting days.
If I may just point out something else, in relation to what was said, apart from Dr. Smile's calmness and being nice to everyone, he had a way of finding planes. And, obviously, we work with, we're young, surgeons under training. We are working with others. We have very impatient people. We have people who see a structure and cut it and it bleeds. And then they say, artery, artery, artery. Whereas Dr. Smile would see what's happening. He would ask for forceps. He would clamp it and cut it. And there would be, when he was assisting me, I was just cutting. And he was saying, there's a blood vessel there. Just wait. So he said, clamp it. And, exactly. So he had a way of finding planes. God had actually used to mark it for him. He could see it. It used to be marked over here, vein here, artery here and all. I think that used to happen.
So nicely said.
Sir is one of those unusual people who is not only a great surgeon, but a great assistant. Because not many good surgeons can actually assist others. As an anesthetist, I have watched that, some of the good surgeons can't assist at all. But sir is a real exception to that. I'd like to get Dinkar in. He's been nice enough to join, though his mother's not well. Dinkar, would you like to say a few words?
Yeah, hi. Hi, Shastri. Hi, everybody. Nice to see all of you. I have some, my teachers, Dr. Anthakrishnan, Dr. Smile, and I used to say, they were two people in total contrast, Dr. Anthakrishnan and Dr. Smile. The sense that Dr. Anthakrishnan is a very scientific and perfect surgeon. So, you know, whereas Dr. Smile is all about art. So he was very artistic. And Shastri, I just wanted to, you know, your comment about God labeling the structures for Dr. Smile. We had Purni to that question. So,
Dinkar, your voice is breaking up. Your voice is breaking up.
Yeah, sorry. No, the thing is, I am on my mobile internet in the hospital. I am speaking from the hospital.
Yeah.
Is it better?
Yeah. Better.
Yeah, I was just saying that Dr. Smile had God to, you know, for him to identify the structures like the artery and the vein to label them. And we lesser mortals had people like Purni to do it for us.
The anatomist.
So, Dinkar, you're one of the few people who have known and worked with Sir rather than Dr. Anandakrishnan. You're one of those who has worked with Sir in the good old days in the 80s or 70s and up to now. So, I'd like you to, you know, say something about this long journey or the two beginning and the towards the end of his career, you're working with him. So, would you like to say something about that? Is he any different now than he was in the 70s or 80s?
One thing I can very clearly say is, other than the fact that his hair has turned totally white, there is absolutely no difference in him in terms of his journey from the time when I first saw him till now. I'm sure he has slowed down in his physical activities because he was a very active sports person. I'm not sure, sir, whether you're still playing tennis and all that. I know Professor Anandakrishnan has stopped. But Dr. Smile is still very active and he takes so much interest in his students as he always did. And even now he comes in, he's for all the classes, he interacts with the students and he has been quite active in operating even till very recently. And I think the entire institution over here, the Mahatma Gandhi Institution, all the people, not only the trainees, but also the faculty look upon him as a master teacher and call upon him whenever we are in any trouble, when you know, during operating or whatever it is. So I think that skill and that talent is still there in him. So in that sense, I will say no, he has not changed at all, other than a slight change in his physical appearance. Even his waistline, everything remains exactly the same as it was at that time. You know, which none of us can actually say that.
So for those of us who don't know, Dinkar is a professor of surgery and he's a into simulation. He's one of the best people under whom you can, you know, get trained on simulation. And despite his mom being not well, he joined us. And thanks a lot, Dinkar. Thank you, and hope your mom gets well soon.
Yeah, she'll be discharged tomorrow. So I'm speaking from the hospital. Touchwood, everything is nothing major. So, you know, that's a big relief. I could not but join. I had to join for something like this, you know, where we are talking with Dr. Smile, Dr. Anandakrishnan, and it's nice to see so many familiar faces here.
Hi, Dinkar.
Who's that?
Purnendu.
Oh, hi, Purnendu. Okay, now there are so many faces in front of me. I can't. You've lost weight, Purnendu. I follow your YouTube channel.
Oh, that's great.
Hi, Vimal. Vimal's Piyush, I can see. Yeah, Piyush is my classmate.
Now, I'd like to now get in Sri Kumar, my classmate who's in Wales. Sri Kumar, would you like to say something?
Hello, Vidya. Hi. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, hi. Everybody has talked a lot about Smiles and AK, so I can't really add much more. But I'm really sorry, Mr. Anandakrishnan, I couldn't join in on your day. Vidya did tell me, but I was actually quite quite away at that time. I think Chaka has been quite loquacious about everything, really, and he has put it quite succinctly. I always felt that what I learned from Jipma was like a three-legged stool, really. One is the knowledge, another is the skill, and the third is sincerity and dedication, which I think both of them are exemplary. I think quite a few surgeons after that, but I must say, you know, I mean, they're still a world apart. I think I've met very few surgeons who can operate to the level that they both do. It's nice to see you, Dr. Smiles, and thanks for last year. I'm sorry I couldn't talk to you then.
Hi, Sri Kumar.
Yeah.
Hi. Oh, I saw you last year. Yeah, yes, last year, but I didn't get a chance to talk to them.
Vidya.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Shanti wants to say a few words about sleep.
Absolutely, sir. Please, ma'am, can you just tilt the screen so that we can see your face nicely? Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Hello, sir. Dr. Smile. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Be wondering what I'm going to tell about you. But one thing that I have always admired is the way you establish rapport with children. Because whenever we send a surgical reference, I have seen you talk to the patient and how you coax them and how you examine them. And even the most uncooperative child, once you come and see, they will allow you to examine. That's what I tell the students. They say child is very uncooperative. I said, you just watch Dr. Smile, how he establishes rapport with them. He'll talk to them about cricket, about movies. He'll just come down to their level. There I can see his grandson behind them. He'll just come down to their level and play with them, and finally they will let him examine. So that's what I would like to check.
I can hardly hear that Shanti has never asked me to any of our patients.
Dr. AK, can I ask something there? Dr. AK, yes. Do you remember you did the youngest child for esophageal reposition reconstruction with colon?
Kartik. Name was Kartik.
I still remember we used to go to visit that child, and the only one that child would cry at would be Professor AK. Every single time, as soon as the child sees his face, he would start.
He was 2 years old when we operated on him. Remember, Sri Kumar?
Yes, I do. I do him very well, actually. He did very nice face.
I'm sorry so to hear that you've already had a session with AK. I didn't know at all, because I was going to ask, why don't we have a session?
Yeah, I think we need to have another session.
I'll tell you something about Meghrath.
Yes,
I'm guilty because at a very short notice, Radha Krishna, whom you all know as Patta these days, asked me. He said, you have to do a series on surgeons you knew, and you start with AK. So first of all, I was scared that I have to interview surgeons, and second that I have to interview AK. In 3-4 days, I just didn't have the time to actually network and get. I didn't want too many people to witness my debacle. So I kept it closed. And then eventually we realized that, so many people are having so much fun, and it's so great to get everybody together. So from now on, I promise that I will make sure and try and reach out to as many people as possible whenever we are all meeting up. Dr. Bagri, are you there? Most of us are, junior to Dr. AK and Dr. Smile. So
why don't you make a group and put all of us in the group? So whenever the next meet is there, you just post in the group, everybody gets to know.
Yeah, Jipma Net Shacks, I would request all of you to join either Learning General Surgery group or Jipma Net Shacks. Both the places we are putting all the notifications.
Send the link to everybody.
Is that on Facebook?
Yes, Facebook.
I hate Facebook.
Okay, now that I have your number, I'll keep you. But you're not even on WhatsApp, so it's very difficult to.
I am. Now I'm on WhatsApp, so I can send you. I think I got your number. I've got a separate WhatsApp number. I'm a paranoid guy. I have all sorts of nefarious activities. So I have different numbers. So
yeah. Giridhar is there. Ramasubramanian is there.
Yeah, just a minute. A few more students of Dr. Smiles. Tamil Maran, would you like to say something? Tamil Maran was one of the first to immediately reply when I reached out to him. And Tamil Maran, please introduce yourself, because you're too junior for most of us.
I don't even know how to say your name, actually, Dr. Vidya. Thank you, for arranging that. That's actually him. It's a real honor.
Tamil Maran, how are you?
For Dr. Smiles.
Tamil Maran.
Hello, sir. Ninga, how are you?
Sir,
So Tamil Maran is a hepatobiliary surgeon and upper GI surgeon, and probably Dr. Smiles will know, but
he's a painter as well. Hello. So I had the privilege of being a PG of Unit 2. And I think when I got the surgical seat at Jipmer, and we're all kind of worried actually where we're going to go, which unit we're going to get. Some units have fantastic reputation, some units people just didn't want to work for whatever reason. And when I was actually informed that I was going to go and join Unit 2, I think literally a dream come true actually. And I had a fantastic experience, absolutely no regrets whatsoever. And even yesterday, I was in the middle of a gullet surgery. I was telling my trainees here that actually the two surgeons I've worked with, that's actually one is Dr. Sir, and I was Dr. AK. And I think I get to meet somebody of that caliber anywhere in the UK. And I think whatever I've learned actually regarding GI surgery in Jipmer, quite a lot of that is still practice. And I still think actually my technique is far superior to some of my colleagues here, and I get excellent outcome. And I think it's just totally, totally thanks to what I've learned under Dr. Smail and Dr. AK. And of course, actually other consultants like Dinkar and Sharat and Dr. Jagadish, all of them actually taught me so many things. I think of all the people I have learned, I think the great Sir and the AK on top of anybody else, actually, even some fantastic surgeons who worked in the UK, but I think they just come easily on the top. And it's more than that, actually. I think the way they interacted with the PGs very fairly. And I never felt actually discriminated for any reason whatsoever. And at Jipmer, and I had fantastic friends, Anand, Deepak, and so many of the Pankaj, so many other friends, actually. And I think it's a close-knit group. But there was always this kind of hidden rivalry between Unit 1 and Unit 2 mainly. And there's some kind of sarcastic comments every now and then. But once you see beyond that, there's a kind of healthy rivalry we had. And it's just everybody was so keen to learn everything under these two top surgeons. And then one of my senior residents was actually Sri Kumar, particularly in acute surgery. And you never know when Sri Kumar will come into the ward, when he'll go. And but he can learn so much from him. And people like Dinkar Sir and all, they've learned so much actually. And so many good memories of that unit. And I think Deepak once mentioned actually before that Dr. Smile made him taste alcohol. I still haven't, I think in that aspect actually Dr. Smile actually failed. I still haven't touched alcohol actually. but we had a good actually, so many parties, really enjoyed it. And absolutely, 100% respect and thanks to these two top surgeons and everybody else who worked with the Jipmer.
Dr. Ravi Prakash, would you like to say something? Dr. Ravi Prakash?
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes. Yeah. Please introduce yourself because many of them may not know you.
Yeah, I am Dr. Ravi Prakash. I am working in Karnataka near Mangalore. Tamil Maran and myself were together in Jipmer at time. Dr. Dinakar Pai. Yeah. I was under Dr. Dinakar Pai, Dr. Jagadish unit, I did by PG.
Hi, Ravi. Long time.
So, it is nice to arrange this program and so that I can get memories of Jipmer, especially on Dr. Smiles. I would like to say that in a case of adhesive intestinal obstruction, Dr. Smile's fingers would be magical fingers and he will get the planes like magic. I used to appreciate especially those cases of adhesive obstruction. It's a pleasure and a treat to watch him. And I still remember his technique of suturing, even skin suturing also, so good. So I try to emulate and it's not possible for me. And thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.
Dr. Bagri, would you like to say something, sir? Dr. Bagri?
You hear me?
Yes, sir. You muted yourself, sir. Please unmute yourself. Yes, sir.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
See,
as Unnikrishnan and Dr. Bharti and all, they pointed out.
Sir, can you just tilt your camera? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hmm. Dr. Smiles told his own story. He became a JDMO when I was there, you know. So I was in Professor Satyaprakash's unit. First, I did my internship in JIPMA, and I did my internship in Dr. Medhirtha's unit when Dr. Smiles was there. So that was the time he said, you must become a surgeon, you know. So at that young age, we were wondering what specialty to take up. But if I became a surgeon, it's because of Dr. Smiles. He's the one who muted me to a surgical career, taught me how to hold the artery forceps and the needle holder in my internship days. And then from that unit, I went on to join MS. I did it in Satyaprakash's unit. And then again, I joined Medhirtha's unit as a senior resident. And you know, the rounds, the pre-operative, that free day, when the list has to be prepared for the next day. That used to be a wonderful thing. Dr. Smiles will give us all a bonda. And then, you know, the list will be prepared. He'll say, give two cases to the chief, and then all the list is yours in the other theater. It was a really wonderful time we had with Dr. Smiles. All the things which has been told about him are all really so nice. We always, even today, we remember him whenever we do our work. It was the golden era, as far as I can say, of JIPMA. Anand Krishnan just came back from Delhi. Dr. Smiles was there, Dr. Satyaprakash, Dr. Chatterjee, Dr. Mehta, Dr. Chowdhury, Dr. Sibbal. Oh my God, what wonderful teaching programs we used to have. I have never seen such a good surgical department in all my life again, ever. And it was wonderful working with Dr. Smiles. That's what I'm saying. So many he has made. If the English word gentleman, there is something, it just fits in with Dr. Smiles. That's all I can say. And later on, I've been associated with him once in a while. And when his son was there in Ramchandra, did radiology, I've interacted with him. Then they called me once, Mahatma Gandhi, for a guest oration. So it's been a real wonderful thing, and so nice to listen to so many good things being told about him. And the way you and Patta have organized this, it for me is both learning general surgery and alumni meet and the association between surgeons and anesthetists, for which what you were saying. And then, you know, we used to have NP seeing Dr. Bale before Dr. Kangle came. Oof, it used to be real things. If Dr. Smile can remember, there was a child for which we did some prenatal, gas insufflation. Those days, no ultrasound and all was there. And Dr. NP Singh was there at the head of anesthesia table. Some gas embolism happened. Oh, what a thing. Who did the thing? I'm sure you'll remember that story. So the surgeons and anesthetists got along very well in JIPMA, or that's what I can say. And even later on in private practice, I had a JIPMarian anesthetist, Raghavendran, all my life when I was in Apollo for 25 years. Oh, we had a wonderful time. So you were saying only cardiac surgeons appreciate cardiac anesthetists. No, I think the pediatric surgeons love the anesthetists the most, because they know the small baby is taken so well care of. All the advances in neonatal surgery have happened because of the neonatal anesthesia. With these words, I hand over the mic back to you. Thank you, Dr. Smiles. Thank you, Professor Anand Krishnan. You have, for what we are today, you have made us all what we are. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Vidya, we have last 10 minutes.
Thank you. Thank you,
Bhagdi. He has to respond.
Just one small comment about Rajkishore Bhagdi. He doesn't know about it, but he was responsible for me doing surgery. As a student, one night I went to the OT late night, and he was in scrubs, and he was resting on one of the trolleys, and I thought it was so romantic and exciting. I said, surgery is what I'm going to do.
For those of you who don't know, Dr. Bhagdi is one of the top pediatric surgeons in he's recently moved to Mumbai, but otherwise in Chennai, he was pediatric, the go-to person for all pediatric surgery. And we are proud that he's also one of our alumni from JIPMA. I'm really sorry we are running out of time. Dr. AK, we are over to you. You promised to do the closing comments. And and those of you who could not speak today, I promise you we will have another one, another meeting sometime very soon. And really sorry if I couldn't give you the time. AK sir, can you unmute yourself?
Yeah, I also would like to speak again. Something I could not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are all here, sir. Yeah, Dr. Smiles, you go first, and Dr. AK can.
No. Now we will listen to another question.
As usual, I have to start with a disclaimer. Because Purnendu told that story about the Harvey House roof. I've been in Harvey House for 3 years, but I haven't been to the roof in my lifetime. Leave alone throw glasses into Bose's house. So as usual, Purnendu made up another story. Now you know why I'm called AK-47, because Smile had PGs like Vimal Kumar and I had PGs like Purnendu. So anyway, Bharti said she was the prince's daughter. I had the prince's son-in-law in my unit, Banerjee. Remember?
Yes. S.N. Banerjee.
S.N. Banerjee. So I met Smile in 77 when I came to Pondicherry. I think the day I joined on 7th of February, I met two people. Or three, Satya Prakash, of course, and man sitting with an angry look and very bushy eyebrows, Dr. Hardan Chatterjee, and Smile. And Smile took me around the department, and he was working with Medhirata, and I joined Satya Prakash's unit. And we had good times with Satya Prakash, Purnendu knows, and many of his contemporaries.
We can have a whole session on that, sir.
That's a different topic. But over the years, 43 years now, since I know Smile and I know Vijaya, they're very, very close to our family, both of them, and Smile is one of my closest friends. And as all of you mentioned, I've yet to see him angry or annoyed or disturbed. But the world has to be in equilibrium. So when we have somebody like that in the department, you also have to have me. So that is why the averages work out. And over the years, we've been friends. We have. He was one of my closest colleagues when I was head of department. But we used to have a number of issues those days with the PMK people becoming ministers and MLAs and all sorts of things, Smile will remember. And a lot of administrative issues. And the trust we have in one another, I can tell you over the years.
Yeah, your voice breaking, Anand.
Okay, I'll shut off my video then. Maybe the voice will improve. Now is it better?
Yes, sir.
Over the years, we have.
We'd love to see you also.
You've seen for 43 years, not enough.
So he's missing you during lockdown, sir.
No, no, he calls me regularly. He's one of the persons who calls me regularly to find out how I'm doing during the lockdown. I'm still in lockdown, by the way. I am in quarantine because I went to Chennai and came back and they've shut me in my house for 1 week. So I'm not. Hello, Tamil Maran. How are you? Nice to see you after a long
time. Nalaka, sir. How are you? It's a long time since I've met both of you. I think next time when I come there, I'll come and see both of you in Mahatma Gandhi Institute. Yeah?
You, Sri Kumar and all that, all role memories, Kulwant. Yeah. There are many other people. So. Yeah. We have immense trust in each other, and I have a lot of faith in his surgical skills. And I'll tell you only one story which I told when I was interviewed by Vidya. She was not so considerate to me as she is today, and I was left traumatized. But now she has practiced and got better. Vidya?
Thank you, sir. Thanks for the compliment.
We had a chief secretary of Pondicherry with little difficult to manage type of family. And he had jaundice and we had investigated him and he required Whipples. And knowing his temperament and the family's temperament, I didn't want to get involved too much in his management. So I sent him to Rangabhasha. I said, Rangabhasha, the best man here. Go and he will do what is needful.
Not for nothing, but Rangabhashyam, he saw him, he examined him and said, you go back to Ananda Krishnan, he'll do a good job. So no need to come all the way to Chennai for this operation. So I had to operate on him. I had to do a Whipple's. And Smile, remember I told him, I don't anticipate, he's a thin man. But anyway, you please hang around till I finish. And he came to the changing room and he waited there patiently till I sent a message. All well, you can go back to your bondas. So over the years, I've operated on members of his family and he has operated on me. So we are very, very close. And it's nice to work with him even after retirement in Mahatma Gandhi Medical College. And it's nice to be in touch with students right till the, as long as you're able to interact with them, that's probably what keeps us going. And I don't know, see, the day I came, within a month, Raj was in the final year of MS, along with, I think, Santosh Pai and Unni was the second batch after I joined, Jagdish, Unni and Dilip Baliga and all that. I got this nickname of AK-47. And by listening to people like Purnendu and Chandru and all that, you'd have known why so. And this one-liners which somebody said, no more one-liners. I have stopped using those one-liners. So the AK-47 has become muted these days. So, but Smile is one person whom I have never seen angry. And I don't know, I once in a farewell, it was his 70th birthday, I think it was, in the department said, I said, I know only one man who has conquered anger. And that is Robinson Smile. And that sentence probably reflects best upon him as a man and human being. And about his surgery, all of you have heard. I don't have anything to add. And it's been a wonderful journey for us for 43 years. And I hope a few more years we continue, God permit. Thank you very much.
Dr. Smile will reply to complete the session.
Pardon? Would you like to reply to him? Reply to Dr. AK sir.
AK has been always like that only. Nothing more to add to him. As he said, we know since he joined in 1977 in Jipmer, he knew him and is very closely associated with me. For any problem, I go to him. Because for any difficulty in clinical situation, you may remember our Pondicherry, former Pondicherry Chief Minister's wife had cholangitis, cholestasis. She went to Apollo and they came back here. And he only, I told him to come and help me to operate on her. But she was so obese and she was in sepsis. So we opened her up and just did everything. We just did a drainage, isn't it?
We did a cholecystostomy and put a CBD in. She was in septicemia. We put a T tube in. Remember? D. Ramachandran. Oh,
yeah. D. Ramachandran.
Yeah.
Former Chief Minister. For any help I need, I always go to him. Even now. That is always there.
So, Vidya, to conclude.
Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you, Vidya and Radhakrishnan. Thank you very much for arranging this. I could meet all of them.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Our pleasure, sir. We're really sorry that we have to cut short because I think Radhakrishna has another meeting to start because lockdown days he is very busy and the learning general surgery has continuous lectures going on. So thanks Radhakrishna. Today you're not going to get any time for yourself. So maybe next time.
Yeah. Well, thanks everyone. And We'll meet next week again. Thank you. Thank you.